Welcome to Economica. Today's video is about population growth and its impact on the environment. According to the United Nations, the world population is expected to reach 9.8 billion people in 2050. Currently, the world population is approaching 8 billion inhabitants. The population is not only growing intensely, but it is also consuming more. This consumption, which is sometimes excessive, impacts the environment and demands huge amounts of natural resources. Some are not renewable, such as iron ore, copper, or lithium. Other non-renewable sources are fossil fuels, which pose a threat to the Earth's atmosphere. We can also talk about land, food, water, and air. The list of resources demanded by the population increase is immense. Despite the alarmism, the world has never been such a comfortable place to live. According to the University of Oxford, 200 years ago, no country in the world had a longer life expectancy than 40 years. And 82% of the world's population lived in extreme poverty. Today, less than 10% of the population is in extreme poverty. This leap in the quality of life was driven by improved education, a drop in mortality, and freedom, as the number of people living in democratic regimes has greatly increased. In addition, the number of working women has also increased dramatically. The fact that at the same time that the quality of life increases, fewer people can be alive is a paradox. The damage to the environment caused by humans since the beginning of industrialization has been disastrous. Today we are consuming natural resources 1.7 times faster than they can be replenished. It means that we need 70% more resources on Earth to satisfy our current consumption and waste production standards. Despite the great population growth in recent years, the fertility rate, that is the average number of children per woman, is decreasing. In 1950, each woman had an average of 5 children. Today, each woman has just over 2 children, which means the population is increasing, but very slowly when compared to what happened in the past 2 centuries. The population of many countries, such as China, Brazil, Japan, and Germany, will be stagnant or even decreasing in 2050. The region of the world that will grow the most will be the African continent. In Africa, the fertility rate is 4.7 children per woman, which is almost double the world rate. Despite political instability in many countries, Africa is expected to increase its GDP volume considerably, which in addition to population growth, may represent a danger to the environment. Anyway, it is not possible to predict exactly what will happen to the environment in the next decade. But with our lifestyle and consumption, today, it is not possible to imagine that all countries on the planet can achieve the lifestyle of developed countries. For example, if everyone in the world consumed as an average American, we would need 5 Earth planets to sustain us. Of course, it does not lead us to the conclusion that we must prevent poor countries from improving their quality of life. It is much more fair and efficient to invest in technologies that reduce the waste produced by humans and that also make clean energy sources cheaper, which will reduce the burning of fuels. The UN says that the best ways to decrease the fertility rate are birth control with preventive public policies, such as the distribution of condoms and contraceptives. Furthermore, to educate the population, especially women. When a woman is in the labor market, the probability of her having many children are considerably reduced. In addition, educating and raising awareness among the population reduces the number of children and creates better living standards for the whole family. To reduce the human impact on the environment, the decrease in excessive consumption is essential. Only a few people care about the environmental consequences of their behaviors. Almost no one cares about the environmental impact of their cars or the process of producing their clothes. Most of them only make a correlation between the satisfaction generated by that product and the available budget. The concern with the environmental impact is almost zero. Not many people will withdraw from buying a pickup truck or an SUV because of its environmental impact. Most will buy it just because they can afford it. And because they like it. Anyway, there is no reason for pessimism. The world has already gone through similar situations, such as the one described by the economist Thomas Malthus, who believed that the population grew in geometric progression, and the production of food grew on an arithmetic scale, which would lead to a widespread lack of food. His ideas could even make sense for its historical context, which was 18th and 19th century England, which was a country with insufficient land available and densely populated. We'll probably find some way of keeping the planet, even if it's with less population and being more productively with less consumption. But, if we do not find any way to reduce our environmental impact, don't worry. Nature never fails. I hope you enjoyed this video. If it was useful for you, give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. See you next time.